Friends, this is 2016 question paper, asked for 6 marks. Just I read out the question. From the following information, prepare cost sheet. Cost of production 10 lakhs. Opening stock of finished goods at 50 rupees per unit, 2500 units. Closing stock of finished goods 5000 units. Selling expenses at 10 rupees per unit sold. Profit 20% on sales. 7500 units were sold. So this is the information. We have to prepare cost sheet for this. Guys, in this question of 2016 for 6 marks, see, he started with cost of production and he asked us to do the cost sheet. See, cost sheet. Cost sheet. See, is manufacturing, how many units we don't know, but he sold 7500 units. Okay, now we have to find out what is the cost per unit. Cost per unit, and also total cost we have to find out. But we don't know how many units we are manufacturing, but is given number of units is sold. See, usually what happens when you want to calculate number of units, what is that? Number of units manufactured. So first you take that calculation of number of units manufacture. This first you take units sold. How many units is sold? 7500 units sold. To this add closing stock of finished goods. Closing stock of finished goods in units. How many units is given? Closing stock is 5000 units. Is closing stock of finished goods is given 5000 units. Now totally we had 12500 units. From this deduct opening stock of finished goods in units. How many units given? 2500 units. That means this year we have manufactured 10,000 units. So we have to calculate for 10,000 units. How many units? 10,000 units. See, why we have to calculate this is, I'll tell you. Okay, the cost of production is given. The cost of production, the total cost is given is 10 lakh rupees. If 10 lakh rupees is the total cost of production for 10,000 units, what is for one unit is minus 4 zeros. Say it becomes 100 rupees per unit. So your cost of production per unit we have calculated as 100 rupees per unit. If 100 rupees is per unit, for 10,000 units it is 10 lakhs, or 10 lakhs total cost of production is given. For one unit, it becomes 100 rupees. Okay. So, to this, what actually we do is, we add opening stock of finished goods. Am I right? See, how many units of opening stock of finished goods is given? Is 2,500 units is given. And it cost is 50 rupees per unit. So, if it is 50 rupees per unit, for 2500 units of opening stock, how much it will be is, it will be 1,25,000 rupees. 1,25,000 rupees. And please don't calculate per unit for opening stock of finished goods. Now if you add 11,25,000 rupees, why we have to add here? There is a plus symbol is there. And don't calculate per unit for this also. Now
we have to minus closing stock of finished goods. See, closing stock of finished goods is given 5000 units. For opening stock is given per unit as 50 rupees. But for closing stock is not given per unit cost. If closing stock of finished goods per unit is not given in the question, then what is the base is cost of production per unit is the base for us. What is the cost of production per unit is 100 rupees. So therefore 5000 units into 100 rupees, this will be 5 lakh rupees. For this also please don't take. Okay, now how much we get is 6,25,000 rupees we will get. Now this is called as cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold. To this cost of goods sold, how do you calculate per unit? See, when you manufacture 10,000 units, you had 2,500 rupees of units of opening finished goods. Totally at the end of the year you had 12,500, but closing stock was 5,000. So total 7,500 units were sold. Units sold were 7,500. Am I right? Yes, this is what units, number of units sold. To this cost of goods sold, we should add selling and distribution overhead. Selling and distribution overhead. So selling and distribution overhead is clearly given. Selling expenses at 10 rupees per unit sold. So how many units we sold? 7,500 units we sold, and selling expenses is 10 rupees per unit. So thereby 75,000 rupees will be your total selling expenses. Now per unit, how do we calculate? 6,25,000 divided by 7,500 units sold. Now cost of goods sold is 6,25,000. Number of units sold is 7,500. So 6,25,000 divided by 7,500.
6,25,000 divided by 7,500.
It is 83 rupees 33 paisa. Now 10 rupees is your selling price, selling expenses per unit. So it will be 93 rupees 33 paisa, and this will be 7 lakh rupees. This is your total cost. Right guys, now what is given in the question is profit is 20% on sales. That means we should add profit here, and he is not given profit directly in the question, but he is given the percentage. What he is telling is on total sales 20% is your profit. 20% is your profit, but we don't know what is the sales. If you assume that sales is 100 rupees and your profit is 20, then your total cost will be 80. Now 7 lakhs is your total cost for 80. What is for 20% of profit? What is 20% of profit? Now 7 lakhs divided by 80 into 20, this will be 1,75,000. This is 1,75,000. How for how many units sold? 7,500 units sold. So this will become 23 rupees 33 paise. And now the total selling price is 116 rupees 116 rupees 66 paise, and this will be 8,75,000. You can cross check with this 8,75 divided by 7,500, because number of units sold is 7,500 units. So 8,75,000 divided by 7,500. So it's coming 116 rupees 66 paise. Say this is a 6 marks question. See guys, the major very important point is this only. Okay, If you don't get this number, means how do you get this number is only when you find out cost of production per unit. Okay, when you want to calculate cost of production per unit, definitely you should know how many number of units manufactured. See, in order to calculate number of units manufactured, first we take units sold, add closing stock of finished goods minus opening stock of finished goods, and this will be your number of units manufactured. If number of units is manufactured is 10,000 units and cost of production is 10 lakhs, per unit will be 100. In the question, he is given opening stock of finished goods per unit as 50 rupees, but closing stock of finished goods per unit is not given. And always we calculate closing stock of finished goods per unit based on the cost of production only. So on this cost of production, on this cost of production only we calculate. So that is when we can solve this question. And please just take this question. If you understood, like my video and share my video and subscribe my channel Sai Study Circle. If you are already subscribed, please ask your friends also to subscribe. Thank you.